What's the best way to invest in times of market upheaval? Should you be making changes in your portfolio? Well, many consider the most important step to build wealth over time is selecting the right asset mix among stocks, bonds, cash, and other investments. David Darst is known as the master of asset allocation. He has authored several books, including his most recent, Mastering the Art of Asset Allocation. He is also the chief investment strategist of Morgan Stanley's Global Wealth Management Group. Deciding how to allocate your assets is not easy. Vern Hayden is a veteran financial planner who specializes in portfolio management using mutual funds and retirement planning. His book, Getting an Investing Game Plan, outlines how to do it. And cash has proven to be an investment that has held its value when others don't. Maximizing cash returns is the domain of Peter Crane. He is president of Crane Data, which follows the money market industry and publishes the monthly Money Fund Intelligence newsletter. Great to have you all here. So what do you do in times of volatility? How do you change what you're doing with your clients? And Vern, I think you told me you don't time the market, but you do time your clients.
Yeah, absolutely.
What do you mean by that?
I think that this has been a great catalyst for investors, not just my clients, but a lot of investors around the country, to re-examine their tolerance for risk, because all of a sudden they found out, hey, this volatility thing went too much for me, and
right.
I can't handle this. I'm losing sleep at night. Okay, then they should do something and reallocate their portfolio down to where they can sleep, which means a change. So I don't believe in, you know, static allocation. I think you got to do some tactical stuff.
So, for instance, what have you been doing with clients that have called you up and said, you know, I'm a nervous wreck?
Well, I'm going to tell you something. We've had four people call out of about 160,
mm-hmm.
and that's not much, because we try to match a portfolio with somebody's risk tolerance, their time frame, and what their objectives are. And those are the three main criteria to create a portfolio for somebody. Particularly newer clients, sometimes you miss it because they are new. You haven't lived through some things with them. And those are primarily the ones that might call, and you've got to do some, you know, tweaking here and there.
Right.
And
so,
that's what we're doing.
So how have you tweaked?
Well, we tweak by increasing the amount of money in a portfolio to what I call hybrid funds. These are managers that can be both defensive and offensive within their own fund and pick the asset classes that they want to invest in depending on the times, and they will shift around a bit. I have found, after a lot of experience doing some wrong things and things that have worked out, that when we leave it up to managers of these hybrid-type mm-hmm. funds, asset allocation funds, whatever you want to call them, that the portfolios end up doing a lot better. Then around that, we have pure equity fund managers that are mostly value-driven.
Right.
And then some real defensive funds that are bond funds and funds that may sell short or do something, but they're proven.
So that's, you know, the portfolio, the mutual funds.
So the
asset allocation is, just give us a couple of names. I mean, what are some of the
core
funds that you're...
For instance, to pick on, you know, Vanguard, Wellesley, or Wellington are,
mm-hmm.
are both asset allocation type funds. I like the American Funds Capital Income Builder. I like Thornburg Investment Income Builder. These are all funds where the managers can figure out how they want to allocate the money, and you pick them based on track record.
Right. Peter, speaking of cash and volatility, is that I know one of the things that you advise as well, it seems to be there's a trend now towards more quality, that's a really important big trend. And as far as the quality of, again, money market funds or where especially people on fixed income could get yield, you know, a lot of them tend to chase yield and they're looking for a higher yield. But your feeling now is what as far as chasing yield? Or is it more dangerous to do that, or are you putting your assets more at risk?
Well, you really don't want to be in an outlier. Is the main point, you know?
And what's an outlier?
Meaning, something. If the Fed funds rate's at 5.25, if a bunch of funds are 5.10 to 5.30, if something's yielding 6%, you look at that and say, you know, what are they doing? You know,
right.
They've got to be pushing the envelope.
So even 3/4 of a percentage point above what the average is, that's a warning signal to you.
It's a major warning signal that you look and say, you know, these people on Wall Street, the professional mutual fund managers. I mean, they're copying each other's tactics. If anyone knows anything that someone else doesn't, you know, someone else is going to steal their idea quickly. And so the returns, particularly in money market funds, the gross returns before expense ratios are just clustered right on top of each other. So they're all doing pretty similar things. You really, want to watch out for somebody that's out there all alone.
Mm-hmm.
And I joke with many investments, you want to be a B student rather than, you know, leading the pack.
Right. David, there was a wonderful quote in the Financial Times by an anonymous hedge fund manager saying, it's been a great time to use your mind rather than a machine. A lot of the computer models have failed these money managers. Is this a better time to go with active managers? I mean, you know, have the models failed?
I think most of us love flying in aircraft on long flights where we know the automatic pilot, but we want to know that a human being, because models may be created that are perfect, but history is not perfect, and human beings are subject to fear and greed, and those are emotions, which Big Blue, Deep Blue, the chess playing machine, was never able to copy. Sweat on your
right.
upper lip.